If you're publishing in the scientific literature, you need to be aware of the problem of predatory open access journals. Predatory open access journals are bogus journals that are exploiting the open access model to make money. Open access journals are a great idea. The idea is that authors pay publishing fees so that journals can make the full text of articles freely available to everyone. The PLOS journals, Public Library of Science journals, are shining examples of this open access publishing model. When it's done with integrity, open access publishing is fantastic. But because money is exchanging hands, this has opened the floodgates for the creation of bogus journals which exist solely to collect money from authors, not to publish high-quality research. Jeffrey Beal, a librarian at the University of Colorado, Denver, has been a leader in calling out this practice and keeping lists of bad publishers and bad journals. Another leader in exposing this whole problem is the journalist John Bohannon. He ran a sort of sting operation that he wrote about in Science in 2013. What he did was he submitted an obviously flawed bogus paper. He describes it as he did a scientific version of Mad Libs, so that he could come up with 255 slightly different versions of the same paper where he took molecule X from lichen species Y inhibits the growth of cancer cell Z. He created a whole bunch of different papers just substituting different molecules and species in cancer cells. And the papers had obvious flaws. Any scientist, no matter how schooled, should have been able to look at Figure 1 and know that this paper was problematic. He submitted this to open access journals, many of which he suspected to be predatory journals. And indeed, of 255 where he got a decision back, 157 of those journals accepted that paper. It was only rejected by 98. In fact, 82% of the publishers on Jeffrey Beal's list actually accepted that paper. So, John Bohannon was able to show that there is this huge suite out there of predatory journals, and they are willing to accept anything for money. Along with the report, Science published a map that shows the location of publishers, editors, and their bank accounts, color-coded by acceptance or rejection of the paper. The locations were derived from IP address traces within the raw headers of emails, WHOIS registrations, and bank invoices for publication fees. India emerged as the world's largest base for fee-charging open-access publishing, 64 publishers, and over 90% of them accepted the paper. The United States is the next largest base, with 29 publishers accepting the paper and 26 rejecting it. In Africa, Nigeria has the largest number, of which 100% accepted the paper. All evidence shows us that these predatory journals are greatly on the rise. There was a 2015 paper in BMC Medicine that tracked predatory journals from 2010 to 2014. You can see it's growing exponentially. Pay attention to that red line on top. That's the total number of predatory journals. They estimated that in 2014, there were about 8,000 active predatory journals. In 2010, these journals published about 53,000 articles. That was up to 420,000 articles published in these predatory journals in 2014. These are probably all or most of poor quality. Authors paid an average article processing charge of $178 per article, so it's a money-making scam. That same paper, they also share that this affects all scientific disciplines. In 2013, Declan Butler this checklist in Nature to help you vet journals, to make sure that you're being careful to not submit to one of these predatory journals. He suggested that authors should check that the publisher provides full, verifiable contact information. You want the full address of the publisher to be available. You also want to check that the journal's editorial board lists actual experts with full affiliations, not just made-up people. You might even want to contact them and ask them about their experience with the publisher because there are known instances when people's names have been borrowed and just stuck on these websites without the person's permission. You want to check that the journal prominently displays its policy for author fees. Open access journals do charge fees, but you want to make sure that these policies are clearly described on their website. If they're not, that's a suspicious sign. Be wary of spam email invitations. You will get a lot of these emails that ask you to submit to journals, or to become an editorial board member, or to speak at a conference. You can tell that these are spam if you look carefully. Always go to the journal's website and make sure that the articles that they are publishing are high-quality articles. Check that a journal's peer review process is clearly described. Make sure that they are actually doing peer review and try to find out whether a journal's claimed impact factor is correct. There is a trend now where these predatory journals are making up bogus metrics. They have names like the Universal Impact Factor, UIF, or the Global Impact Factor, GIF, or the Journal Impact Factor, JIF. These are all popular but bogus metrics made up by predatory journals. They sound a lot like the real thing, so be careful not to get sucked into that. There are lists people publish of supposedly legitimate open-access journals. The lists are not perfect, but at least the journals listed there have gone through some vetting. You might want to check before submitting. You can check with the Directory of Open Access Journals or the Open Access Scholarly Publishers Association. You can check there and make sure that the journal you're submitting to is listed there. Finally, use common sense. If something looks fishy, if it looks like spam, it probably is. So just be careful and be aware of these predatory journals.